from Wikipedia. Live free as Encyclopedia. Vocoder, a combination of the words voice and encoder, is an analysis synthesis system mostly used for speech. In the encoder, the input is passed through a multiband filter. Each band is passed through an envelope follower, and the control signals from the envelope followers are communicated to the decoder. The decoder applies these amplitude control signals to corresponding filters in the synthesizer. It was originally developed as a speech coder for telecommunications applications in the 1930s. The idea being to code speech for transmission. Its primary use in this fashion is for secure radio communication, where voice has to be encrypted and then transmitted. The advantage of this method of encryption is that no signal is sent, but rather envelopes of the bandpass filters. The receiving unit needs to be set up in the same channel configuration there is in this ISA version of the original signal spectrum. The vocoder has both hardware and software, has also been used extensively as an electronic musical instrument. The vocoder is related to, but essentially different from, the computer algorithm known as the phase vocoder, whereas the vocoder analyzes speech, transforms it into electronically transmitted information and recreates it, the voter, from voice operating demonstrator, generates synthesized speech by means of a console with 15 touch sensors. basically, consisting of the second half of the vocoder. The twin manual filter controls the data highly trained operator.
Vocoder theory. The human voice consists of sounds generated by the opening and closing of the glottis by the vocal cords, which produces a periodic waveform with many harmonics. This basic sound is then filtered by the nose and throat, a complicated resonant piping system, to produce differences in harmonic content, formants, in a controlled way, creating the wide variety of sounds used in speech. There is another set of sounds, known as the unvoiced and plosive sounds, which are created or modified by the mouth in different fashions. The vocoder examines speech by measuring how its spectral characteristics change over time. This results in a series of numbers representing these modified frequencies at any particular time as the user speaks. In simple terms, the human voice consists of sounds generated by the opening and closing of the glottis by the vocal cords, which produces a periodic waveform with many harmonics. This basic sound is then filtered by the nose and throat, a complicated resonant piping system, to produce differences in harmonic content, formants, in a controlled way, creating the wide variety of sounds used in speech. There is another set of sounds, known as the unvoiced and plosive sounds, which are created or modified by the mouth in different fashions. The vocoder examines speech by measuring how its spectral characteristics change over time. This results in a series of numbers representing these modified frequencies at any particular time as the user speaks. In simple terms, the signal is split into a number of frequency bands. The larger this number, the more accurate the analysis, and the level of signal present at each frequency band gives the instantaneous representation of the spectral energy content. Thus, the vocoder dramatically reduces the amount of information needed to store speech, from a complete recording to a series of numbers. To recreate speech, the vocoder simply reverses the process, processing a broadband noise source by passing it through a stage that filters the frequency content based on the originally recorded series of numbers. It should be noted that information about the instantaneous frequency, as distinct from spectral characteristic of the original voice signal, is discarded. It wasn't important to preserve this for the purposes of the vocoder's original use as an encryption aid, and it is this dehumanizing quality of the vocoding process that has made it useful in creating special voice effects in popular music and audio entertainment.
History: analog vocoders. Most analog vocoder systems use a number of frequency channels, all tuned to different frequencies, using bandpass filters. The various values of these filters are stored not as the raw numbers, which are all based on the original fundamental frequency, but as a series of modifications to that fundamental needed to modify it into the signal seen in the output of that filter. During playback, these settings are sent back into the filters and then added together, modified with the knowledge that speech typically varies between these frequencies in a fairly linear way. The result is recognizable speech, although somewhat mechanical sounding. Vocoders also often include a second system for generating unvoiced sounds, using a noise generator instead of the fundamental frequency. The first experiments with a vocoder were conducted in 1928 by Bell Labs engineer Homer Dudley, who was granted a patent for it on June 21, 1938. The vocoder was introduced to the public at the AT&T building at the 1939-1940 New York World's Fair. Dudley's vocoder was used in the SIGSALY system, which was built by Bell Labs engineers. Alan Turing was briefly involved in 1943. The SIGSALY system was used for encrypted high-level communications during World War II. Later work in this field has been conducted by James Flanagan linear prediction-based vocoders. Since the late 1970s, most non-musical vocoders have been implemented using linear prediction, whereby the target signal's spectral envelope, formant, is estimated by an ALPO-IIR filter. In linear prediction coding, the ALPO filter replaces the bandpass filter bank.